السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي ربي زدني علما. Welcome back to Quranic Language Made Easy and I'm really sorry for taking a long break. Remember me in your duas so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it easy for me to continue inshallah. And today we are going to do the lesson 24 from unit 2 from Quranic Language Made Easy book. That is Al-Fi'l Al-Naqis Al-Wawi. So this is the third type of irregularity that is called as Naqis. In the previous videos, we covered the different types of weak verbs, that is Mithal and its types Mithal Wawi and Mithal Yai. And we covered Ajwaf and its types Ajwaf Wawi and Ajwaf Yai and Ajwaf with Alif. And today we are going to do Naqis, and again this has four types. First type is Naqis Wawi, which belongs to family Nasara Yansuru. That is, the example is Da'a Yada'u. And the second type is Naqis Yai, which belongs to Daraba Yadribu family. And the example is Hada Yahdi. And the third type, Naqis, which belongs to Fataha Yaftahu family. The example is Sa'a Yasa'a. And the fourth type is Naqis, that belongs to the family Sami'a Yasma'u. And the example is Laqiya Yalqa. And today we are going to do Naqis Wawi. And the example is Da'a Yada'u. Let's see what exactly Naqis is. The meaning of Naqis is defective or faulty. A word is considered naqis when the last root letter or the lam radical is a vowel. This means that this irregularity affects the endings of words. And the defective verbs or al-mu'tal al-naqis are the verbs whose last original letter is a weak letter. The original weak letter can be either a waw or a ya. So the word naqis is the weak of lam, which has the last letter, the lam letter is a weak letter on all the six small mujarrad families. That is the six babs which we learned previously. The Nasara Yansuru, Samia Yasma'u, Karuma Yakrumu, Fataha Yaftahu, or Hasiba Yahsibu, Daraba Yadribu, right? So this is called Naqis because in most of these verbs, the last vowel or the harka is omitted. Let's see, for example, Da'awa. So they can either replace the waw with a ya and say da'aya, or they can replace the waw with an alif and say da'a. Meaning the three vowels are interchangeable. Now which of those three sounds the smoothest? So it is da'a, of course. So instead of saying da'awa, they would say da'a. So da'a is written with an alif. This is actually a clever way of telling that this is naqis, naqis wawi. Well, if you want to look up in the dictionary, we're not going to look it up as dal, ayn and alif. Rather, we'll search it for dal, ayn and waw. Okay? So, if you look at the word shaka, then the root letters are sheen, kaf and waw. Because alif is never a root letter. It's either a waw or a ya. So, if you look up in the dictionary, you'd be looking for sheen, kaf and waw. Like when you say nasara, where all the letters are consonants, that's easy to say, but you can't say da'awa, that's not allowed, or shakawa, that's not allowed. The conjugation table for madi, da'a. Da'a, da'awa, da'au. So here, the huwa, third person masculine singular, the waw is replaced with a straight alif. So it's da'a. For the huma, the dual, the waw comes back and it becomes da'awa. So whenever it is naqis, wawi, the waw comes back. And the plural is da'aw. So for the plural, it's not gonna be like nasara, nasara, nasaru. It's not da'avu, okay? Because it's hard to pronounce. So what they'll do is, they will drop a waw and it becomes da'aw, okay? So that's why it's da'a, da'awa and da'aw. Now, the aw sound, right? We never heard this before in the weak words. Aw sound is only for naqis. You don't get this in other weak words. Like if you have qala, qala, qalu, like it ends with u, or ba'a, ba'a, ba'u, or you had this khafa, khafa, khafu, right? They're all ending with u. But here in naqis, it ends with aw. And even the mithal verbs, wa'ada, wa'ada, wa'adu, or ya'isa, ya'isa, ya'isu, right? But only in naqis, it's aw for the plural. So, it began with da'a, and the plural is gonna be da'au. The au sound is for naqis because the regular plurals ends with u, but naqis plurals ends with an au. So for hiya, it's gonna be da'at. Instead of, like, if you go with nasarat, right, it should have been da'awat, right? But they drop the waw and they say da'at, okay? And then for the the dual, it's da'ata. And again, we have da'auna because this is the feminine plural. So it's gonna be da'auna. Why da'auna? Because the root letter is a waw. So you will bring back the waw. And from there onwards, it's easy. Da'auta, da'autuma, da'autum. Da'auti, da'autuma, da'autunna. Da'autu, da'auna, da'auna. Let's see the mudare, present or future tense. Da'a, yada'u. For the huwa, the alif is replaced by a waw for ease. So yada'u instead of yada'a, right? Da'a, yada'a. It's not going to be like that. It's going to be yada'u. Yada'uvani, yada'una. So for the masculine plural, it's going to be yada'u'una. Okay? So if you go by nasa, yansuru, yansurani, yansuruna, it should have been yada'uvuna, right? But this is not easy to pronounce. So what they do is they drop a waw and it becomes yada'una. And for third person feminine singular, hiya, it's gonna be tada'u. Tada'uwani. Yada'una. Hey, wait. Did you notice something? The third person masculine plural and the third person feminine plural, hum and hunna, they both look exactly the same. Yada'una and yada'una. Right? Why is it so? So the hum and hunna are same in writing and pronunciation because the way you make hunna is you take the huwa version and add a noon to it. So yada'u and then you add a noon, it becomes yada'una. Okay? But for here, it was actually yada'uvuna, right? The waw is dropped here. This noon is noonun niswa and this is the noonun rafa. Okay? And then from there onwards, second person, it's tada'u, tada'uwani, tada'una. And for the anti, second person, feminine singular, anti, it should have been like tansurina, right? If you go by tansurina, it should have been tad'uvina, right? It would have been tad'uvina, but this sounds weird. So because there's no ui sound in Arabic or u sound in Arabic, this is ui, right? Uvina. So what they do, they make it smooth and they make it tada'ina, the waw is dropped. So it's tada'ina, tada'uwani, tada'una. Again here, tada'una and tada'una are same. And for first person, it's ada'u and nada'u. So now you know that the third person masculine plural hum and the third person feminine plural hunna are the same. Now the question arises, how do you know in Quran, when you read the Quran, how do you know that it is a masculine plural or the feminine plural? Let's take an example of Surah Yusuf. رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا يَدَعُونَنِي إِلَيْهِ. So you see it's يَدَعُونَنِي. It says, my Lord, the prison is dearer to me than what they invite me to it. So when Yusuf alayhi salam says that these women are calling me for something evil, that word is actually feminine plural, right? Yada'una. So it looks like it is masculine, right? But the context, who do the Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam referring to here? The women, right? So here, yada'una is feminine plural and not masculine plural because yada'una and yada'una, they both look the same, right? So yada'una is feminine here because it's talking about the women. And Yusuf alayhi salam is talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instead of talking to the women, right? Who are in front of him, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for him is more visible than these women. And another example we have is Surah Ghafir, tada'unani li'akfura billahi wa ushrika bih. So you call me that I disbelieve in Allah and to associate with him. So this tada'una is the second person masculine plural because there's no feminine, no women or anything in this ayah. And one more ayah is from Surah Baqarah. We have فَنِصْفُ مَا فَرَضْتُمْ إِلَّا أَنْ يَعْفُونَ. Then give half of what you have specified unless that they women forgo it. So again, يَعْفُونَ, يَعْفُونَ looks the same, right? It's talking about if you divorce them before you touch them, then you have already specified for them an obligation. Then give half of what you specified unless they, the women, agree to forgo it. So يَعْفُونَ is feminine here. So important points above the table formats is in the Madi past tense, the alif is changed into the original letter waw, starting with the third person masculine dual. And in the Mudare, the table, the third person masculine and feminine plurals are identical, like yada'una, yada'una, as well as the second person masculine and feminine plurals, tada'una and tada'una. Let's take the Quranic example from the book, A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitani Rajeem, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّا دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ. Who is better in speech than the one who calls people to Allah? So this is huwa, third person masculine singular. دَعَوَ اللَّهَ رَبَّهُمَا لَئِنْ آتَيْتَنَا صَالِحًا. They both pray to Allah. It's huma, right? It's dual. دَعَوَ اللَّهَ. So if you grant us a righteous child. And وَإِذَا مَسَّ النَّاسَ دُرٌّ دَعَوْ رَبَّهُمْ. When trouble touches people, they cry to their Lord. So here دَعَوْ, this is what أَوْ sound is for, plural. So this is third person masculine plural, هُمْ. وَكَأَيِّن مِّن قَرْيَةٍ عَتَتْ عَنْ عَمْرِ رَبِّهَا. So here we have like دَعَتْ, this is عَتَتْ, this is هِيَا, third person singular, feminine, right? عَتَتْ. And many nations disobeyed the command of their Lord. And قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي دَعَوْتُ قَوْمِي. So here we have da'autu, right? This is first person ana, right? Da'autu. He said, my Lord, I call my people. And وَبَلَوْنَاهُمْ بِالْحَسَنَاتِ وَالسَّيِّئَاتِ. We tested them with prosperity and adversity. So this is balawna is from bala, yablu. And this is the first person plural, nahnu, balawna. وَاللَّهُ يَدَعُوا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ وَالْمَغْفِرَةِ. So yada'u is the mudare, and this is huwa, right? Third person masculine singular. Allah calls towards the heaven and forgiveness. أُولَٰئِكَ يَدَعُونَ إِلَى النَّارِ. They call towards the fire. This is plural hum. وَهُمْ يَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابِ. And they recite the book. تَلَا يَتْلُوا يَتْلُونَ. This is also hum. And we have some more examples. رَسُولٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ يَتْلُوا صُحُفًا مُطَحَّرًا. So we have تَلَا يَتْلُوا. And then we have فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ. So رَجَى يَرْجُوا. So whoever is hoping for the meeting with his Lord. يَرْجُوا. And let's do jazima and nasiba first, and then we'll do amar and nahi, because I want to show you all how it changes when it is in the majzoom state, in the jazima state. Let's take nasiba, and the nasiba works with accusative particles, and we all know the accusative or the nasiba particles are li, kai, likai, likaila, an, li, an, allah, hatta, and lan. So for nasiba, the light version, and we all know that the normal version is yaf'alu or yansuru, and the light version is yansura or yaf'ala with a fatha, and the lightest is yaf'al with a sukoon on it, right? For the nasib, yansuru would be yada'u, this is the normal form, and for the nasib, the mansub form would be yansura, it's yada'uwa. Okay, so lan plus nada'u becomes lan nada'uwa with a fatha on the last letter. And the examples for that are linabluwahum ayyuhum ahsanu amala. So this is bala yablu nablu linabluwa. Because of li, huruf nasiba, it becomes linabluwa. Wama ataytum mir ribal liyarbu fi amwali liyarbuwa. Right, so this is raba yarbu liyarbuwa because of the nasiba li. وَإِنْ تَعْفُوا أَقْرَبُوا لِلتَّقْوَى. So تَعْفُوا, because of أَنْ, it's the noon drops, it becomes تَعْفُوا. And the jazima are the words with jassive particles, right? The lightest version. And they are لِي, لَا, لَمْ, لَمَّا, إِنْ, وَلْ, and فَلْ. And also the conditional words. So here we get rid of the vowel altogether, right? We'll say يَدَعُوا, right? Without the vowel. Yada'u. Why? Because jazima or the lightest version is supposed to be having a sukoon, like yansur, right? The problem is their normal version already have a sukoon, right? Yada'u. This already have a sukoon at the end, right? So the waw already have a sukoon in the mudare. So in case of nasiba, the light, I can just put a fatha, yada'uwa, right? But in jazima, I can't go back to normal. So what they decide to do is, they just get rid of the waw altogether. That's how they make it jazima. So yada'u becomes yada'u. So lam plus nada'u becomes lam nada'u. As a reminder, yada'u is the normal version. Yada'uwa is the nasib version, the light version. Yada'u is the lightest version, the jazima version, where you drop the waw altogether. And the example for jazima are, فَلْيَدْعُوا نَادِيَهُ سَنَدْعُوا الزَّبَانِيَهُ. فَلْ, because of فَلْ, يدعو become the wow drops it becomes يدعو and سندعو وإن تدعو مثقلة إلى حملها. So we have because of إن تدعو the wow drops. Now the command أمر. So what are the steps for making a command? You take the second person مضارع تدعو and then the second step is you make it جازمة and how do you make it جازمة by dropping the wow it becomes تدعو and then you get rid of the علامة مضارع تا and it becomes something like this which is not pronounceable right so if this is the case what is the next step you have to get the hamzatul wasl and what would be the haraka on the hamzatul wasl it's gonna be a dhamma right udu so the chart would be udu udu'a udu udu'i udu'a udu'una and the examples are wa'fu anna waghfir lana so here wa'fu is there afa ya'fu so and pardon from us and forgive us warzuquhum fiha waksuhum so waksu but provide for them and clothe them so this is kasa yaksu and utlu ma uhiya ilayka min alkitab so tala yatlu utlu recite thumma ud'uhunna ya'tinaka sa'ya so then call them ud'uhunna And then we have the prohibition or forbidding nahi. And how do you do this? You take the mudare and you make it majzum and you have a la of forbidding. La tansur becomes la tada'u, the wow drops. La tada'u, la tada'uwa, la tada'u, la tada'i, la tada'uwa, la tada'una. The noon niswa will not drop. And the examples are وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ تُرِيدُ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا So وَلَا تَعْدُ The wow drops and let not pass beyond your eyes. تَعْدُ لَا تَغْلُو فِي دِينِكُمْ So here we have تَغْلُو Do not commit excess in your religion. And one more example for لَامُ لُونُ التَّوْكِيد is وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصِ So here we have بَلَا يَبْلُو وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ Now let's see the masdar. Masdars are unpredictable in the mujarrad, the six small families. Okay, we don't know what pattern it follows. They are just unpredictable. Let's take some examples of masdar. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الذين آتيناهم الكتاب يتلونه حق تلاوته So this is تلاوتي تلا يتلو تلاوت It's a recitation. إن ربي لسميع الدعاء Indeed, my Lord is all-hearer of the prayer. So, dua. There's one more. Da'a yada'u dua. Wa'atau utuwan kabira. And this is maful mutlaq. And become insolent with insolence, with great insolence. U'utuwan. Wali yubliya al-mu'minina minhu bala'an hasana. So, this is bala yablu. And from that, we have bala'an, a trial. Now let's see the ism fa'il in naqis, the active participles. So this usually come in the pattern of fa'ilun, right? Technically, if you go by this pattern, it should be da'ivun, okay? Like fa'ilun, da'awa are the root letters. It's going to be da'ivun, right? But no u sound in Arabic, remember? So here the last letter is dropped and it's going to be da'in, which means the caller, right? This fa'il, the doer, the fa'il. Da'in is the caller. So here, they don't like the u sound, u, da'ivun. So they get rid of the waw and make it da'in. So the rafa nasab jar would be da'in, da'iyan, the mansub, and the jar is da'in. Did you notice something here? The rafa, the marfu, da'in, and the jar, da'in, they look exactly the same. This is the first time which is happening that the marfu and the jar are the same. Right, da'in and da'in. So here, this da'in is different from this da'in. This was actually da'ivun, right? Did here, they drop the waw. Because da'ivun, they don't like the u sound, right? The tanween at the end is only there to remind you that this was da'ivun. And the waw is dropped and replaced with a tanween. And for the dual, it's going to be da'iyani, da'iyaini, da'iyaini. And for the plural, it's going to be da'una, da'ina, da'ina. And the plural, it's going to be da'una. Okay, it was supposed to be da'iyuna, you, right? But the Arabs don't like that you sound. So the ya is dropped and it becomes da'una. And again for plural, da'iyina. It's hard to pronounce. The ya is dropped and it becomes da'ina. So this is the chart. Da'in, da'iyani, da'una. Da'iyan, da'iyaini, da'ina. Da'in, da'iyaini, da'ina. It doesn't matter which family it belongs to, Daraba, Samia, or what are the other different types of naqis, like naqis wawi, naqis yai, naqis sa'a, yas'a, naqis laqiya, yalqa. All of them will have the same ism fa'il. They are going to be like da'in or hadin, hadiyani, haduna. We are going to learn that in the coming lessons, inshallah. The light version of da'in, which means that if you add an al to it, it has two options. Either it could be with a ya, ad-da'i, or it could be without a ya, ad-da'i. And when you make a mudaf, it becomes da'i, okay, with the ya. Always remember for the mudaf in naqis, the ya is there, da'i. And the examples are, wala adin, and dhanna annahu najin minhuma, najayanju najin, wa innahu fir'auna la'alin fil ard. عالٍ أستكبرت عم كنت من العالين. This is the plural one. فإني قريب قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعاني. So here we have indeed, I'm near, I respond to the invocation of the supplicant, دعوة الداعي. This is with the أل, and here they are not using a يا, الداعي. This is مضاف إلي. إذا دعاني, when he calls me. لو أنهم بادون في الأعراب. So this is بادون plural. إلا الذين هم أراذلون بادي الرايا. So بادي, بادية because of إلا in plus لا. So it becomes بادية ناسب. And the Muslim chart would be داعية, داعيتان, داعيات, داعية, داعيتين, داعيات, داعية, داعيتين, داعيات. And examples are لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية. So عالية is the feminine. And then we have أسلفتم في الأيام أيام الخالية والعاديات ضبها. So عاديات. فالتاليات ذكرى تاليات. عاد فأهلكوا بريح صرصر عاتية. And now the مفعول, the passive participles مفعول. So this would be in the pattern of mafa'ulun, right? If you take mafa'ulun pattern, it's going to be mad'uvun, right? Which is correct, except the two vowels are there. You can see two vowels. So what's the rule in Arabic? When there are two vowels, they are fused together and there is a shadda on top of it, right? They're similar letters next to each other. So they make it mad'uvun with a shadda on it. It has a shadda, so it's regular. Nothing is dropped. So it's da'in is the fa'il, the caller, and mad'uvun is the maf'ul, the one being called. And we have mad'uvun, mad'uwani, mad'uwuna. مدعوان مدعوين 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 مدعوة مدعوتان مدعوات مدعوة مدعوتين مدعوات مدعوة مدعوتين مدعوات. Now let's see the passives. The passive ناقص verbs are the مجهول. And the ماضي مجهول, what you do? It should be in the fu'ila or musira pattern, right? So here it's gonna be da'awa would be du'iya pattern, okay? It's not gonna be du'iwa. Why it's not du'iwa? Because the root letters are dal, ayn, and waw. Again, remember the rule. Du'iwa is u sound and Arabs don't like the u sound. So they're gonna make it du'iya. He was called. So du'iya, du'iya, du'u, du'iyat, du'iyata, دعينا and دعيتا دعيتما دعيتم دعيتي دعيتما دعيتن دعيت دعينا دعينا. The example for ماضي مجهول is فمن عفية له, but whoever is pardoned for it. ولا يأبى الشهداء إذا ما دعوا, they are called. وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا. تليت. And the مضارع مجهول would be If it is du'iya, it's gonna be yud'a, right? Like yunsaru or yudrabu. It's gonna be yud'a. He is called or he will be called. So here, du'iya, it's gonna be yud'a. Either you can write yud'a with an alif, but here they prefer the alif maqsura. So it becomes yud'a. So yad'u simply becomes yud'a. So the mudari majhul chart is yud'a, yud'ayani, and yud'auna. Notice here, it was supposed to be yud'avuna, the vowel drops, and it becomes yud'auna. Tud'a, tud'ayani, yud'aina, right? And tud'a, tud'ayani, tud'auna. And for this, it's gonna be tud'aina. It was supposed to be tud'avina, like tunsarina. Tunsarina, it's gonna be tud'avina. Again, it's weird, so they drop the vowel and they make it tud'aina. Tud'ayani, tud'aina. Now, notice the singular and the plural, they both are same. Tud'aina and tud'aina. Ud'a, mud'a, and mud'a. You can also write it yud'a with a dagger alif like this, yud'a or tud'a. The Quranic example for mudari majhul are illa ma yutla alaykum tala yatlu yutla, except what is recited on you. كل أمتين تدعى إلى كتابها تدعى will be called يوم تبلى السرائر the day will the secrets will be tested تبلى وقد كانوا يدعون إلى السجود وهم سالمون so يدعون لا تسألوا عن أشياء إن تبدى لكم so in because of in تبدى. Let's take the examples from the book. وَإِذَا تُتْلَ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُنَا when our signs are recited to them. This is مُدَارَ مَجْهُول. وَإِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ and when they are called to Allah and His Messenger. دَعَى يَدْعُوا دُعُوا this is also مَادِي مَجْهُول. إِذَا دُعِيتُمْ فَدْخُلُوا when you are invited, enter. This is مَجْهُول. ادعوا الى سبيل ربك بالحكمه this is a command amr invite or call to the way of your lord with wisdom ادعوهم لآبائهم call them by names of their fathers this is again amr ولا تكفوا ما ليس لك به علم and pursue not that of which you have no knowledge so this was تكفوا with the waw because of law of prohibition it become jazm it becomes تكفوا the waw is dropped وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ Be sure we shall test you with something of fear. So, بَلَا يَبْلُو because of the nasib, huruf nasiba, it becomes وَلَنَبْلُوَ Okay, now let's see the sarf chart. This is sarf saghir, right? Because it just has madi, mudare, masdar, fa'il, maf'ul, mudare, majhul, madi, majhul, and you have amar and nahi, right? And the one which we did, the different charts for madi, different chart for mudare, different chart for fa'il, maf'ul, and different chart for the majhul and amar and nahi, that is called as sarf kabir, right? We did each and each charts individually, right? Da'a, da'awa, da'au, right? All those things we learn. And this is sarf saghir chart. Da'a, yad'u, du'a'an or da'watan. Masdar can be, masdars are unpredictable. You don't know what pattern they follow. Da'in, you just have to look up in the dictionary. Du'iya, yud'a, du'a'an, da'watan. And maful would be mad'uun. Amar is udu'u and nahi is la tad'u. We have this ayah from Surah Qasas. إِنَّ فِرْعَوْنَ عَلَى فِي الْأَرْضِ وَجَعَلَ أَهْلَهَا شِيَعًا So when you are praying and the imam recites this ayah, إِنَّ فِرْعَوْنَ عَلَى right? We might think that this عَلَى is like the preposition, the huruful jar, إِلَى عَلَى بِيْفِي right? You might think that it's عَلَى right? The both the pronunciation is exactly the same right? عَلَى but don't get confused. This is not the حروف الجر على this is على this is the ناقص one على يألو and the chart would be على علوا علو علت علتا علونا علوتا علوتما علوتم علوتي علوتما علوتنا يألو يألواني يألونا تألو تألواني يألونا تألو تألواني تألونا تألينا تألواني تألونا أعلو and نألو Let's do the vocabulary for last letter waw naqis al wawi verbs. Bala yablu, tala yatlu, jatha yajthu, jala yajlu, دعا يدعو دلا يدلو دنا يدنو عزا يعزو عصا يعصو عطا يعطو علا يعلو أنا يعنو غفا يغثو غلا يغلو ذرا يذرو فجا يفجو ربا يربو قصا يقصو رسا يرسو قفا يقفو سجا يسجو كسا يكسو سما يسمو لها يلهو سنا يسنو مكا يمكو سها يسهو ملا يملو شها يشهو نجا ينجو صدا يسدو ندا يندو صفا يسفو ضحى يدهو عثا يعثو نسا ينسو نفا ينفو. So Jazakallahu khairan for watching. Inshallah, in the next video, I'm gonna take the next lesson, that is lesson 25, that is Naqis Yai. And if you find anything beneficial from this video, it is from only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if there's any mistake, it's clearly from me. So Jazakallahu khairan for your time to watch the entire video. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for you all to learn, understand the Quran and implement in our lives, and also pass it on to others. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. And if you have any questions or doubts or suggestions or improvements, please post it on the comment section below. Or you can email me on qlme2017@gmail.com.